Right. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for taking time out of your busy schedules and coming to listen to us talk about a fundamental aspect of the sign industry, one that is little remembered. It's the education of the workforce. One of the foundations of the European Sign Federation is that we strive to have an educated workforce across our footprint. And the reason for that is that we want a level playing field, that everybody that works in the sign industry understands the minimum requirements of what is needed to be able to make a sign, whether it's a vinyl sign or a built-up letter or something, whatever it is, it could be anything. The question asked is, why do we need an educated workforce? But actually, the question we should be asking is, how do we educate the workforce? Because if you ask why you need an educated workforce, you shouldn't be in employing people in the first place. Because if you don't have educated people working for you, what is the point of actually having a business? Now, we all rely on state education for when people come through and grow up. They leave school or university with an education. We rely on that when people first come to us and work in the sign industry. But when they arrive at the sign company, it's all new to them. Everything is new, new machines, new ways of working, everything else. So it's how does an employer know that the person they're employing actually can do the job? He can do it three ways. He can do it, first of all, by employing them, letting them get on with the job, and then seeing how well they do. Now, that can always end in disaster because they don't know what they're supposed to be doing. They don't understand the principles of certain machinery, certain requirements, certain legislation, certain standards. He can train them on the job, which is great because the employer knows that that person is going to be trained and will get the knowledge that he wants them to use. The problem with that is it takes time. And while you're running your business, have you got the time to go and train someone to go and do something? Or, and this is a more common way of doing it, is actually asking someone if they've got proof or evidence that they have the knowledge that they profess to have. In other words, do they have a certificate that says they can actually add up and subtract and take away and make calculations? It's further complicated here in Europe by the simple fact that I'm talking English, but I'm looking around here and I can see at least a dozen different languages. Not only can I see a dozen different languages, I can also see a dozen different requirements from each country and from each business. Each business will want something different from the next business. So we've got to try and cater for everybody, but not make it too specific. So instead of training to the absolute high standard so that someone can walk into a business and say, here's my certificate, I'm trained to the very top level, that would be fine. We can achieve that if everybody wants to partake in that, but nobody does. You want to employ people that you can bring into your factory and start them off on day one with the minimum requirements knowledge and let them get on with it. So we've turned it round slightly. We've actually said instead of going to the high standards, we'll go to the basic standards that we expect as a federation that everybody that's employed throughout the footprint of the federation to actually know and possess that knowledge. Well, that's fine and dandy. But then the next bit is, how do we go about doing that? How do we actually present this information to people for them to actually gather that information? We've come up with an online training program and a certification system for employees in the sign industry that they can take during their own time, whether it be during work, on the train, not driving, at home, but in a certain space of time, they can actually go online and take each module and work their way through it until they come to the end of the education and possess a certificate saying they have this knowledge. The final goal is for a competent workforce across the European Sign Federation footprint. And the reason for that is because it provides high quality products it reduces waste. There's nothing worse than employing somebody and they make it wrong because they didn't understand the fundamentals of how to measure something. And you've got to go and make it again. All your profit's gone straight away because you've got to make it again with new materials. It meets standards. More and more in Europe, standards are having to be met because it's desperately important that when you make a sign, or you present a sign, or you fit a sign, it's done safely and properly. And in addition, we also get the benefit from the ESF and the associated associations that come with each country for further standing in the sign community. Now, before I hand over to my colleague Heiner, who's going to take you through, hopefully, this, a comment I often hear from people is, why should I pay for my employee to receive training, which they receive and pass their exam, and then they leave? I always answer that and say, well, consider this. What would happen to your business if you kept untrained employees and they stayed? Heiner, please.
First of all, you've heard why online training, and I'll make the part we online, how online training will become, and I will change to the German language. Excuse me, please. First of all, I hate PowerPoint, and that's the reason why I come with another software, which is called Mind Manager, and allows that you can see all the arguments on one page. And who is interested in getting this page, may the paper wrote his email address, and he can get it too in English translation. But now about the project. I'll go directly in the middle of the testing system, and I'll show you how it goes. Und now gehe ich zu Deutschland, zur deutschen Sprache über. Sie sehen jetzt hier eine Reihe von Argumenten. Wir haben in Deutschland eine eigene Lernplattform, über die wir das Wissen von Arbeitnehmern, von Mitarbeitern abfragen können. Wir haben auf europäischer Ebene darüber diskutiert, wie wir das in ein internationales System überführen können. Und wir haben hier eine ganze Menge Rahmenbedingungen geschrieben. Sie sehen jetzt hier die ESF-Erwartungen, the goals David has sent to me. Und da stand dann die Plattform in the moment only for Germany, Great Britain and France. But the most important word is in the moment. And it would be necessary that we add other languages if there comes the Greek which want to use the system, and if comes the Portuguese to use the system. I will make it very short for you if I have more interesting things. We discussed the languages we will use. And we also looked, is this possible in Finland? And is it possible in Portugal? And we decided for a software which is used in Finland by about 300 organizations, schools, high schools, and in Portugal is used by more than 1,000 schools and something else. And that's the ground while we decided to use open source software. Open source heißt, there is no responsibility from the German association, there is, more important, no responsibility for Heiner Dippel, for me. I'm 65 years old, and then the responsibility should last only some years. And this software has a lot of possibilities. You can make knowledge tests, you can integrate videos, you can all the things which are used in tailor learning. And I will show you one point. The software has a very structured roles for the user. You see here, there is a guest, there is a Teilnehmer, that's an employee in the future. You have a trainer role till the manager. And that makes it possible that we decide to develop a European system, and we can give this rights to every person in every country, and he can develop his own courses. That was very important for us, that we can show a system which can be used in all the countries. I will show in a few minutes you what possibilities here are. It will be very difficult to decide which answer will be given in a country to the same in the different countries to the same problem. If you have any questions to the electric system, the answer in Greek will be another way in Sweden. And that made it necessary that there will be a central departure from the ESF, where some defined questions and defined knowledges must be written down, and every country must translate this in its own language. Let me change to another system. That's not easy. Here you can see, I hope so, which languages are available. You see here, Azerbaijan, Danish, Dansk, English, Pirate English, I don't know what the Pirate English is. You also can Afrikaans, that's the South African languages, they are all available. Okay, thank you. All these languages are available, and it's only necessary to there's not enough place for my mouse. Only a click will be here. And then you can integrate it in the system, and that is very important for European Association, which have members in all these countries. And now we can change to another system. We had made a little course to electric, and I have some questions. I will change, I will collect the answers. At which point starts the Bereich high voltage? Is there any? Oh, she's away. We will answer this question. Do you understand this question? Do you understand this question? When starts? See? Okay, let's see. That's right, I know. And now you can take the next question. What is to do with the waste of Leuchtstoffröhren? What's the correct? Lamp recycling. There are the answers. Special waste in the glass container. you can cut it for to have more place, and you can do it into the house waste. And this shows the system which is behind. You can define a pool of questions, about 1,000 pools, and you can make a generator which generates in every round new questions. And you have too the possibility that you can make a test system. You have 10 questions, and to have 80% to you have to give right answers, and then you can get the course. That's all defined. And here is naturally Sondermüll. And I chose the electric course, as I discussed with David, that's one of the most problematic parts in this, as every country has his own rules. What's over here? Oh, that's a very interesting question. Is there anybody able to translate this?
Can you put efficiency of light sources in increasing sequence? The first
setzen Sie die Wirkungsgrad von der Lichtquelle aufsteigen in die richtigen Reihenfolge.
Yeah, which light source is the most efficient one? The first, you can only choose one answer. A is incandescent, then LED, then halogen, and then the fluorescent lamp. The next one is first incandescent, then halogen, fluorescent, then LED, halogen, etc. So make up your choice, which one?
Lithium, halogen, halogen, LED, Lichtstoffe, halogen, grid.
Yeah. Actually, it must be an increasing sequence. Anybody wish to reply instead of me, whose preference would be D?
Too late. Okay, let's. that's a translation problems. Okay, I show you the possibilities of system. You can decide whether there is only one answer correct, or a single choice system, or a multiple choice system. You can change as every question. Here is a starting page. You can see we have decided to, in the first step, to make these languages available. You can change German, English, French, and Italian. I've shown that it's no problem to add any other language to this. And if I change this in Italian, you see it's changed. You see all the things which are important in the Italian language. It's a very mighty system. I'm in administrator role. You can see what you can, but that will I show in German. I understand Italian. it's very easily to change all these positions. You have here a lot of things, and the most of them is in the website administration. This system is based in online system. It is it's based on in the web, and you can change, make all the changes you want. Now I want to discuss with you a special view. We are interested in your opinion, which themes should be the first we do. I'm the opinion that the first for motivating the employees is that we take the theme security. I think all the employees have a positive motivation to this theme, as it's in their own interest, and in the starting phase it will be free for all. All which are interested can use the system, and we will develop, by discussed it with David, the security aspects in the first phase. And later, when we change to English and to electric or in class preparations and something else, that will be not free. But that's a long way to develop such a system in Europe. You agree to safety in the first phase? Okay, we prepared something in this direction, but that will not be shown. Here, I'm ready in the moment. I've shown you a system which is ready for future, and I hope that will a good future for the European sign, and we will do our best to make you a good basis that you can add your own interests in the system. Thank you very much. I changed in the later only in English. It would be, it was awfully for you, but I thank you for your